Yo, what is up, everybody? It's your D, your Rebel, your God, Such and Such, King Sergeant, aka Lover 92, here for the first time in Atlanta. I probably drove down here, but we're here in Atlanta for what is a Southern Fried Gaming Expo here for Key Clip 430. Here with some good friends of mine, of course, Mr. Dustin Diggs and Clayton. Yeah, so we're here. Thanks to my he thought I was waiting. I could be close. So we're here for Southern Fried Gaming, and like I said, Clayton, you know, gave us passes of different things here for us. So this place is cool. It's like a lot of gaming, tabletop, lots of like, you know, vendors. And it's actually a nice spot. Like I said, this is my first time here in Atlanta, and this is gonna be something good. So we're here for day one. About to be done in a few, but I'll definitely get some more video for day two. So we're gonna pause here at this point, but I'll get back to y'all in a minute. So don't you worry. All right, we're here, day two of the concert. I know the other day was kind of, you know, short. We got a little bit late, but it's been pretty good. So we're definitely gonna be showing you guys a whole lot around here. There's so many things. I promise you, so many things. I'm actually excited to show. And of course, I had a one with the Link Squad. You know what I'm saying? So let's get this booming. Okay, so for some of you may know, yeah, I always do a lot of conventions, whether it be video games or whatever, or anime, but this right here is a little bit different. So this is more of the board game, tabletop. There are arcades and video games on the other side, and like I said, this is a really nice hotel, nice event. I got a whole lot of vendors here, and of course, like I said, this is Atlanta, so some of these guys are gonna be new to me. They're gonna be recognizable to everyone else, because it's just always a big part of life to actually expand a little bit more. Let's say we got all types of vendors from all over, and this is one of the rooms. The bigger room is going to be on the other side of the hotel, but this is very nice. Ooh, we got tabletops right around here. These are the old arcade game. I actually played a few of these back in the day.
Not, yeah, every time I rock, you know that I do it. I spit with the fluid. Carter Deans is like the Brace Park, I keep it the truest. It doesn't matter though, I'm running undercover. I'm smoother than butter, I said I'm about to smash this beat. Mario Brothers, yeah, when I probably flow, I'm rocking off the top of those. You understand that I'm jumping, getting the shrooms like I was Mario. I don't wanna fight though, you know that I freestyle right, bro. I said like Mario, cause I'm laying down the... Okay, that was too much, I shouldn't do that. I forgot there were kids here. It doesn't matter up the top, cause Carter Deans is about to get weird. Yeah, when I spin it, you know that I'm freestyling. When I'm freeing up, I said kinda like Zelda, cause tonight we linking up.
All right, y'all, this is where the internet happens. This is the vintage computer, somewhat indie games. Yeah, because we got like a lot of stuff here. Some good old arcades. I'm gonna get in front of y'all. So there's a lot of computers. I know, like I said, the other room that we'll see later is definitely gonna be different, but we do have like a lot of creativity. Of course, we got some VR. I actually did that once. I almost lost. I think it was a zombie game I was playing on here. There's a Nintendo party hash. That's a nice one. Old VR, how you doing?
Hey, good, how are you?
All right, so what we got here in the VR section?
This is Potato Party Hashabouts. This is a multiplayer game. It has both VR and mobile players playing with each other. VR players are drawing, and the mobile players are guessing what's being drawn. So it's up to 8 people on mobile devices. You just download the app for free. On mobile, and then join your friends who got VR, or play in the same space and switch the headset around, take turns, so it's a party game.
Alright, so right now, I guess he's just adjusting in the game?
Yep, exactly. He's in a lobby right now, so his friends went off to play something else, and he's waiting on them to come back, so he's just doodling and having a good time in the lobby.
VR is a lot to handle, so be careful on that.
Yep, Potato Party hash it up.
And I like how each has all his theme here. The God Tater, Napoleon Sputter Knight, I guess I'm winner. Raiders of the Lost Boy, I like that. Yeah, definitely cool. I definitely want to get one of these. I'm going to get this one.
Yeah.
Yeah. King Potato. Now, this big room alone, this here is a conquest. This is kind of like your tabletop. Now, I've seen these. We used to go to Fantasia in St. Louis. And this is basically like where a lot of craft is going to be put in play. All these are painted individually, because I know people can do that. And of course, rules and cards and just battle plans, it's all strategic. But there have been a lot of players here getting their game on. I like that. How's it going, fellas?
Hey.
Yeah, this is like landscape mode here. Yeah. It's amazing all the time and craft you put here. How's it going, fellas?
Doing well, how are you?
Yeah, it's the whole lot. So, you mind explaining a little bit about Conquest with me?
So, it's a large fantasy, this is Last Argument of Kings, which is a large fantasy rank and flank game. We also have a skirmish game, too, that we can play, but they all use the same models. It's a war game that comes from Greece. It's fast, it's deadly, it's a little bit more affordable than some games, and it's a lot of fun to play.
Now, for some of the characters, I know a few people did it. Like, did it take a while to kind of paint these, or to kind of really craft these, or is it kind of like a pre-made set?
Well, you do have to assemble and paint the models. I usually say that you get out of the game that you put into it. It's a full hobby that you're getting into. So there's assembling if you like building models. There's painting and coming up with color schemes for creative stuff. And then when you're actually on the field, there's a lot of creativity and flexibility and making your army, and then playing the game, which is a lot of fun.
Okay, yeah, because I'm in St. Louis. I know a lot of people that kind of, you know, do like the RPG games and everything else in between, but like this right here is just always, it's all, everyone has a story, has like a style. I do like that a lot, man.
Oh, yeah.
So it's definitely, so now how long has Conquest been a thing?
It's been around for 4 years.
Okay.
And it's hot. I mean, we're coming out with new factions constantly. There's new models constantly. We even have, if you were to go online and look at the newest models on pre-order, you would see the Tauntaur, this massive Brachiosaur with units on the back, and the Thunder Chieftain. Well, we have that model, the painted model from the company, here today.
Ooh.
So they're constantly sending stuff out here. There's a lot of support. And I mean, you can see there's a lot of people playing the game.
Now, where can we find Conquest? Like, where can we find, like, the website, you know, the handles, all that?
So you're going to want to look up the company Parabellum or Conquest, or Parabellum Conquest, and they have models for both games because they're interchangeable. They've got all the rules for free, and then a list builder online for free as well. That's my big draw for this game is, I mean, obviously you're paying for the models, which are a good deal compared to some other games out there, but then all the rules and everything you need to play are free online. They're fully into supporting the game.
All right, cool. Thank you so much for your time. Guys, get your Conquest on. Okay, now we're on the side with the old computers. And like I said, some of these, I actually know some of them. I always grew up with the Apple computer, like the old big colored ones and the gray ones. But these right here, these are before my time. I'm too young. look at this. Oh, buy these. I'm gonna buy all these computers just for my room. So we got like, so the ones I remember, so this one I definitely not played with, but I've seen the Macintosh Classic. Of course, you got all the other components and everything else. Ooh, I've seen it. It's beautiful. That's definitely beautiful, man. So it's definitely a worldwide, you know, history of computers. We got all these. Oh, ooh, I could actually buy one of these right now if I could. Right behind you, I'm sorry.
Yep, weird.
So, yeah, it's like a whole lot. Ooh, I like that. I'm gonna buy it right now. Now, this one I seen from another console. I forgot where it's from, but yeah, this is like a old Coleco joystick. I want that TV. Yeah, so there's definitely like a lot going on here. It's just so much to really pack in here. I gotta tell you, I remember that one. I forgot where I saw that from. I remember seeing a long time ago. We got like one of the little compact computers. The diagram of all the consoles, PCs, and all that, the handhelds. It's definitely amazing this area. Like I said, I'm just like astonished with just how far like tech can come through. Cause like I said, we had a back then we had a, it was a Windows computer. I forgot which one it was, like a 95 or 98. Yeah, it definitely, like I said, it's just something, it's just like, wow. You don't get, you know, technology like this anymore. Okay, history fact. When I was young, I, of course, we had, everyone had cable at least, but like, channel 99 will always be the weather, and this is accurate weather right here. So we're gonna be, it's gonna be getting a little hot today,
yeah,
I believe.
You just walk past the 64 up here.
Y'all remember the Weather Channel back in the day?
On Mac. Mac TV? No, I don't remember.
I remember it was a phone number we would call for time and temperature. Remember that?
Oh, okay.
What time is it you would call a phone number and tell you time and temperature?
And then the old TV guy right here.
Oh, man.
Dude. How come the good times went away?
TV doesn't show videos on it. It's still the show. So.
See, I would like a TV like this, man. I got too many TVs at my house, though. But, like, these monitors here. Oh, here we go. This is one that's active. Get with your weather, kids. All right, y'all. So, right now, about to do a costume contest. I'm basically, of course, Earth Link. So, there's a lot of people here, too, like, geez. So, we'll see how this goes out. And I'm just going to have a whole lot of fun with this. Now, this here is my area. Gonna be soon my room. This is where all the consoles are. These are, like I said, some of these consoles I had never seen. I probably heard some, but never seen. So it's definitely a thing where I'm like, dude, where were these when I was born? So, I mean, you got the NES, you got the Sega Master System. I actually still want that. So we got a lot of other, you know, consoles. We got some, oh, I should remember that one, the SG, that's the old Sega. Sega Master, the Duo, we got the Viscom. I like these TVs though. Definitely love TVs. We got the Turbo Graphics, which I've seen a few times. I haven't played that much of. Of course, Sega Genesis. We got the Sega Genesis was the only one that was actually multiple consoles. So it's definitely some different varieties. Some Super Nintendos. Of course, we got the Virtual Boy right here. I don't know what he's playing, but I'm glad I actually bought mine. Now this right here, the Atari Jaguar. I would like to own one just because. I know it's, they have the limits, that's cool. Sega Saturn, one of my personal favorites. Then of course you got the PlayStation. Ooh, I think I see these controllers a little bit. I wanna buy one of those. Got some 007. Oh, wait. No, I remember. This is the Ultra 64. Yeah, that's the Ultra. So that right there, that was supposed to be what the N64 was, but some problem having here. That's the really N64 there, of course. So, yeah, the Ultra 64, it was a, I mean, it was still a thing, but it wasn't released because, like I said, they just changed a whole lot, but yeah. So, we got a whole lot. You got the GameCubes, all three, and I think, they got the Game Boy Advance, like that for a minute. And so, and then, like I said, you got these kind of, like this right here, this is the Retro, I believe, Deccan Combat Vision TV Core. Now this right here is like a phone or something, with like a little handle, it's kind of nice. Supervision, the Casio, I remember those. I think I've seen a little bit of that, the MSX2, nice graphic, quick, very nice graphic right there. Like I said, this is the part where I'm like, dude, I want to buy all these. Like I said, this is all console areas. And it's like, I want them, like now. Yeah, the Wii over here, you got the PS3, you got the Xbox, there's some Halo. Like so many things here. Of course, more Halo here on the bigger screen. And over here, I think it's more PlayStation and Xbox. So it's definitely this right here. Like I said, this is like, ooh, I was Mega Man. So now that I try to play with my controller, didn't work. We got some Mortal Kombat. Definitely gonna get in that soon. So yeah, that's the game. This is the game and console area. Now over here is the PC area. So this is now the PC. Throughout time or throughout his days, we've been to the retro vintage computer room. Comparing that to now is like, the gaming for the internet has changed a lot, and it's definitely a masterpiece in this game. There's like a whole lot of computers. There's a whole lot of computers over here and over in that section. You know, like I said, computers are always going to be the dime a dozen type of game console for a lot of players. Of course, that's where a lot of people stream most of the time. It's where everyone kind of comes in and says, hey, you know, let's get on the keyboard and play. So definitely a nice concept here. We got some, oh, we got Xbox Ones on this side. I didn't see that part. Yeah, so this had more of the Xboxes. Hey, all of them Xbox Ones. So it's definitely a, well, the Xbox, I'm sorry, not everybody, but the newer Xboxes. We got some racing over here. It's so cool. Ladies and gentlemen, the big room itself. This is where all the games, the pinballs, arcades, vendors, everything alike. Like I said, we just been through the board game room, or like the tabletop room. But this right here, this is huge. So we, like I said, we were just here the other day. Oh, we got cloud. So we were just here the other day, and I'm just like, dude, I could actually live here. I would like to stay here and work for these guys if I had the chance. Like, this is amazing. A little go-kart. Yeah, and this over here. Now, over here, this is the pinball tournament area. So this is where all the best pinball players are coming in, and they are just going for the points. They're going for the scores. They're going for the title. There's other, like, sections where the pinball is. But this right here, like I said, this is where all the high terms are. This is, like, good tables, too. Very, very good tables. We got my favorite machine right there. We got, hold up, check out the machine. Pride of Pinbot, I love that so much. So we got some good classroom. We got Mandalorian. We got Zelda. I like that one so much. So it's definitely a lot of history in this table, and it's just amazing. So everyone's participating here. Ooh, that's nice. I like that. 8 Ball Deluxe, I like that. And then of course we got some of the top four. But ooh, Iron Maiden, that's cool, I like that. So, like I said, oh, Willy Wonka, that's actually nice. What the Everlasting Cop Soccer, I like that. So, pinball to me, I definitely like, you know, the concept. And depending on the table itself, again, it's always like the design.
I got a hold of it. I only played it twice. I own one.
Yeah, so many. This is the tournament section, but there's more around everything else. Now, this here, a little bit loud as hell. So this here is the other side. This is the pinball area. This is where all the classics here. We got a little bit arcades on one end, and we got vendors over there. We're gonna check them out. Now this is what I was playing the other day. This is Pinbot. Now my favorite here is basically the Bride of Pinbot. I played on the PS2 and the PSP, but Pinbot is definitely good. But yeah, we got like a whole line of this hand now. Bucky O'Hare. Ooh. See, the show not played the game yet. We got WrestleMania. Like I said, we got like, pinball has always been like a prime favorite from. Yeah, I played that the other day. It's pretty scary. I love it so much. We got Venom. This is where all the good classics are. So it's like Venom Arcades, all pinball. We got Foo Fighter pinball, Mandalorian pinball, again, Avengers, Godzilla. We got all types. All types of Venom. Look at that, man. Pretty. 007, Dr. No, we got lots of oh wow, we got only twice. Like I said, it's very well put in the market when you got like certain like trends, whether it be games or movies, a tournament of like, you know, arcade style. Now, this one here I've seen a lot of those. We got more. This end, we got old style Galaga. This is like the old wood frame arcades. We got Mystical Man, which I'm never going to try to get on. I haven't been on this side, surprisingly. Oh, we got Tron. Oh, we got the old Outrun. Yeah, we got the OG Outrun on here. You're tripping, bro. What's up? You're tripping. Yeah, like I said, this is. I'm actually glad I came here. There's so many games
that I've seen for so many games that I have played, and half of them are just like, wow, where was I when this happened? All right, we got way more on this hit. Look at this shit. Look at that. Cowboy speed, I played that a little bit. Crazy taxi. Yeah. Hey, Clay Tribe, what are you doing, dog? Surprisingly, I've not been on this side. I've been like everywhere else but here.
Yeah, I feel like I missed this side. Oh, this is a $10 per item. And oh, everybody wow. is dragging through it.
You got some good old merch for you. Oh, now that game is fun. With three screens, that's fun. Tank, how you doing? We got some Tank. Now that I played this on a Wii. Yeah, I played that on a Wii, and that was cool. We got Vapor Tracks. We're gonna need to work on your games. We got all types of beer. So much to do here. So much to buy. This is crazy.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, it's very rare when you meet a celebrity that's like, all right, cool. But like, when you meet an Instagram follower that you also follow back, it's amazing. So here, we got Imona Arcade. So we're here, still here. She's doing her live stream for Godfather. You wanna say something to all the people out there?
Yeah, watch us on Twitch. It's DRI374. We're live right now.
Hello!
Give up and serve him a drink
of blood. Go for the knees! Y'all, day three here at Southern Fried Game Expo. This has been actually fun. We definitely did a whole lot as far as, you know, games, vendors, met few the cast members, we got some music in, some dancing, my leg is still killing me. So it's definitely a fun trip, especially driving from one city to another in like 12 hours flat, because of course we had a whole lot of stuff, but it's definitely fun. So, I definitely want to thank my friend Clayton for driving us. Of course, me and this. Y'all want to say hi real quick? You want
to
say hi real quick?
Who are we saying hi to? Your mom. Hi, Keenan's mom.
This is YouTube.
Well, that's only Keenan's mom. It's only people that watch it.
Yeah, so this has been a good one, man. I definitely want to thank all the people that came here, all the people that basically just made it live and happen. So, who knows, maybe we might come back again. It all depends. We'll see how life is for me. So, like always, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat, TikTok, all that, man. You know, we got it all. This has been a good video for 4:30. Of course, 4:31. I'll probably do a recap, and I'll see you guys when I see ya. Peace.